Do you ever wonder how people create those timestamps in the playhead of their video so that you can skip around to different parts? Chapter markings, I guess YouTube probably calls them. Well, in this video, I'll show you how to create custom markers inside of DaVinci Resolve that you can export and use to just kind of copy and paste into the video description to create those chapter markers inside of YouTube. So the first thing, obviously, we have a project here in DaVinci Resolve, and once you are finished with your edit and you're ready to export, you could actually have already gone ahead and exported this out, but then just come back into your timeline, and you'll just have to manually go through and determine where you want those chapter markings to be based on what it is you're saying. In this video, it's actually gonna be pretty easy because I created these little graphics here for each little section, so I can just pretty easily find where all those sections are going to be and put the markers there. So you want to make sure that you're not selected on any video or audio track, that your playhead is just where you want it to be, and then hit the M key and it will create a marker where your playhead is. And then you just double click on that marker and you have pop-up menu where you can actually create names, write notes, keywords, and change the colors of the marker. So we're just going to name these what you want the chapter marker to be on your YouTube video. So I skipped the first one, so this actually made our second one here. You don't have to mess with the duration, but if you did want to create custom markers for other purposes in DaVinci Resolve to correspond with like sections of your video, you can just make the duration of these markers whatever you want. And an easy way to do this, it's kind of a bonus tip here, is just make it like 10 seconds, and then you can come back here and then just drag this out for as long as you need it to be. And then anytime you hover your mouse over that section of the marker, it'll pop up with all that metadata that you input in there. Aside from just creating chapter markers for YouTube videos, it's another useful way to organize your timeline so you can quickly see what's going on your timeline with these chapter headings or with these markers. All right, so I'm gonna go back to the first one, create a marker here, just hit M, double click, name it, and hit okay. And I'm just gonna speed this up, pretty much get the idea by this point. The next thing to do after we've made all the markers for our video is come up to the top left next to the media pool and the effects library is something called the edit index, which is essentially like a history of everything that you've done on this timeline. There's a lot of stuff you can do in this edit index, but it's, I guess, more for high level editors, people who are doing very complicated projects and they need to troubleshoot and just, I don't know, a lot of stuff in here we don't need, but it does have the things that we do need. So click these dots here, the three dots, and go to show markers, and you can show all markers, but if you only need the blue ones or certain color, like if you color coded your markers, you can just click that. All of our markers are blue, so we could just click all or click blue. Either way, doesn't matter. So now it's going to trim down all of that metadata into just the things that we need. So if we scroll this over, we can see here that it's got our markers and the notes that we made or the names that we gave them. You can reorganize these things, drag them around. It doesn't really matter when you export them. It's going to export everything that you have shown here in the edit index. So once we have the edit index showing our markers, you can close that edit index down and then open up your media pool again, right click on the timeline, hover over the timelines to get that drop out or pop out menu, hover down over to export, and that drop down menu, the very bottom one, is edit index. And then it's gonna ask you to name it and save it. So we'll just name it something. And then you have two options. This is a Windows PC, so you've got the options for a .csv that you can open up in Microsoft Excel, or you've got a tab delimited values that you can open up in a text or text plus folder. So whichever you prefer. I think it's probably easier to manipulate if you save it as a CSV. And these are going to be the same thing on a Mac, just with the respective programs that open up these kind of files. So we'll save it as a CSV and just put it where you want to put it. So now we'll just navigate to that folder. If you don't have Excel, you can just open this up in a Google Sheets worksheet as well, and it works the exact same way, but we'll just open this in Excel. And this is what you get. Now, I am not an Excel pro here, but what we're looking for essentially is just the notes. So we'll just drag this out so we can see notes here, and then record in and record out. It's basically what a second different. So yeah, I guess you could technically use either one and it would be close enough, but we'll just use the record in and we'll just hide everything else that we don't want to see. So just click and drag, right click, click hide, I don't really need those numbers either, I suppose. And so now we can just Control A or Command A and Command and Control C to copy. And then just go to our YouTube and just open up the video where you can edit the description. Just click in the description and Control V or Command V. And then you have all of the time codes for the chapter marker. So you just delete everything here that we don't need. I should have just deleted all of these numbers. All YouTube needs here is the minutes and seconds. So we'll just kind of backspace these over so we can see better. And you could have done this too inside of Excel and just sort of edited these down to what you do or don't need. I don't know if it's easier to do it in Excel or just easier to do it here. I don't like Excel, so for me it's just easier to do it here. So we don't need these last two digits also are, so it goes like this. So we have hour, minute, second, and then frame. So we don't, all the YouTube needs is the hour, minute, and seconds. And again, for the vast majority of users, you don't even need hours because we're only dealing in minutes and seconds. So we gotta delete the frames out of the values because YouTube won't know what to do with them. And you can, as far as I know, it doesn't really matter. You can leave these hours in here too, or you can just go ahead and delete them. For me, I would just delete them just to make it cleaner because you only have a limited number of characters. If you have lengthy descriptions, I mean, you've got 5,000 characters, so it probably won't matter. But I just like to have it a little bit cleaner just so for people who are actually scrolling through the entire description, it doesn't look like a shit show for them. I would also put a value for the intro, which you can just make zero, assuming that your intro of your video begins at zero. I didn't make a marker for that because it's just easy enough to just write, type in 000, and I'll just clean this up. And that's it. So you should just be able to save this, or you can write, I usually just write timestamp, or you could write chapter marker on top of this and save it. And then if you open your video, now we have all of those chapter markers. So that's it. It's pretty simple. There's a little bit of work involved, but nothing is ever that easy, I suppose. But this does make it a lot easier than sort of just writing down all of the or taking note of them somehow by going through your video and just writing them down on a piece of paper or writing them down in a text document or something. This way, at least you can automate it to a certain degree and do a little bit of copy and paste. Also, making those markers in DaVinci Resolve is something that you can utilize in different ways as opposed to just using them for these chapter markers for YouTube videos. So hopefully you got something out of that as well if you didn't already know that. So if you found that helpful or valuable in some way, feel free to like the video. That would be nice. If you didn't like it, hey, what can I do? Just try to do better next time. If you want to see more videos like this, feel free to subscribe. That would be fantastic as well. And otherwise, we'll just see you in the next video. So appreciate it.